Morning children, in your previous class you studied about the division of the decimal numbers by another decimal number. Now today we will solve the exercise 2.7. First one, find 0.4 divided by 2. You have to find 0.4 divided by 2. Convert this into fraction, 4 by 10 divided by 2. Again, this equals to 4 by 10. Take the reciprocal of 2 into 1 by 2. 2 ones are 2, 2s are, you got here 2 by 10. 2 by 10. See children, on dividing a decimal by 10, the decimal point is shifted to the left by one place. You will get here 2 is there, here 10 is there, after one digit give the decimal point, 0.2. Take second one, 0.35 divided by 5. Convert into fraction, 35 divided by 100. Take the reciprocal of 5 into 1 by 5. Multiply the numerator, 35 into 1. Or you can cancel here only children. 35, 5 ones are 5, 7 ones are. 7 ones are 7. 7 by 100. See, 2 zeros are there here. Shift the decimal point to the right side by 2 places. See, 7, 2 zeros are there here, count from right to left here, one digit is already there here, add one more digit here, 0.07, here 2 zeros are there, shift the decimal point from right to left by 2 digits here, 0.07. Take third one, 2.48 divided by 4. You can write it as 248 divided by 100. Take the reciprocal of 4 into 1 by 4. 4 ones are 4, 6 are 24, 4 twos are 8. You got here 64 into 1, 64, 100 into 1, 100. 2 zeros are there. Shift the decimal point from right to left by 2 digits. Right here 64, 2 zeros are there, from right to left. Shift the decimal point here after the 2 digits, 0.64. Take second main now, find first one, 4.8 divided by 10. 4.8 divided by 10. See children, you already know that on dividing a decimal by 10, the decimal point is shifted to the left by one place, that is 4.8 by 10. On dividing a decimal number by 10, the decimal point is shifted to the left by one place, that is, see, shift the decimal point to the left side by one place, 0.48 will get here. Second one, 52.5 divided by 10. Again, 52.5 divided by 10. You know that children, on dividing a decimal number by 10, the decimal point is shifted to the left side by one place because 10 is there here, that is 5.25. Take third one, 0.7 divided by 10. 0.7 divided by 10. Here 10 is there. Here on dividing by 10, shift the decimal point to the left side by one digit, that is 0.07. Take third main children, find 2.7 divided by 100. You can write it as 2.7 divided by 100. See children, you know that when we divide a decimal by 100, the decimal point is shifted to the left side by 2 digits because here 2 zeros are there. That is, 1 digit is there here and one more digit to the left side here. You will get 0.027 because whenever you divide a decimal number by 100, the decimal point is shifted to the left side by 2 places. Take second one. 0.3 divided by 100. Shift the decimal point to the left side by 2 places. Already one digit is there here and one more zero here. That is 0.003. Take third one. 0.78 divided by 100. 0.78 divided by 100. See children, 1 0 is already there here, one digit is there. You want 2 digits here because 2 zeros are there in 100. Shift the decimal point to the left side by 2 digits. Now add one more 0 here, 0.0078. Take fourth main. Find first one, 7.9 1000. See children, here in 1000 three zeros are there. On dividing a decimal number by 1000, the decimal point is shifted to the left by 3 places because here 3 zeros are there. Here one digit is there already. You want another 2 digits here, add 2 zeros. That is 0.0079. Take second one. 26.3 divided by 1000. 26.3 divided by 1000. Three zeros are there here children. You know that on dividing a decimal number by 1000, the decimal point is shifted to the left by 3 places. Already 2 digits are there here, add one more 0 here, 0.0263. Take third one. 38.53 divided by 1000. That is 38.53 divided by 1000. Again in the same way, shift the decimal point to the left side by 3 digits here. Already 2 digits are there. Add one more 0 here, 0.03853. Take fifth man. Find first one. 7 divided by 3.5. That is 7 divided by, convert into fraction children, 35 by 10. That is 7 into reciprocal of 35 by 10 is 10 by 35. 7 ones are 7 5s are. That is 10 by 5 equals to 10 by 5. 5 ones are, 5 twos are, you got here 2. Second one, 36 divided by 0.2. That is 36 divided by 2 by 10 equals to 36 into 10 by 2. 2 ones are, 2 ones are, then 2 ones are, 1 will remain here, 16, 2 8s are, 18 tens are 180. Take third one. 3.25 divided by 0.5. That is 325 by 10 divided by 5 by 10. That is 325 by 10 into 10 by 5. 10 ones are 10, 5 ones are 5, 6 are 30, 2 will remain here, 25, 5 5s are 25, you will get here 65. Take 6th man children, a vehicle covers a distance of 43.2 kilometer in 2.4 liters of petrol. How much distance? How much distance will it cover in 1 liter of petrol? How much distance will it cover in 1 liter of petrol? Solution children, see, given that total total distance covered by the vehicle in 2.4 liters of petrol, 2.4 liters of petrol equals to 43.2 kilometer. And distance covered in 1 liter of petrol equals to 43.2 divided by 2.4, that is 432/10 divided by 24/10. 432/10 reciprocal of 24/10, that is into 10/24. 10 ones are cancel here. You divide 432/24. See children, you can divide here. 12 2s are 24. 12 3s are 36. 12 3s are 36. 43 minus 36, 7 will remain there. 72. 12 6s are 72. You will get here 36/2. Again divide here. 2 ones are 2. 1 will remain here. 16. 2 8s are 16. That is 18 kilometer. 18 kilometer. Therefore, total distance covered in 1 liter of petrol is 18 kilometer. See children, in this the total distance covered by the vehicle in 2.4 liters of petrol is 43.2 kilometer, and you have to find out the distance covered in 1 liter of petrol, that is 43.2 divided by 2.4. Convert into fractions. 432/10 divided by 24/10, that is 432/10 into reciprocal of 24/10 is 10/24. 10 ones are cancels here. Again 12 2s are 24, 12 3s are 36. 43 minus 36, that will 7 will remain there. 72, that is 12 6s are 72. 36/2, that is 18. 2 ones are 2, 1 will remain here. 16. 2 8s are 16, that is 18 kilometer. Therefore, the total distance covered in 1 liter of petrol is 18 kilometer. Understood children? Till now we studied about the division of the decimal numbers. We solved the exercise today. See, still some more problems are remaining in the exercise. Whichever I have not solved, you solve those. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you.